They came together to join in the celebration. The annual Feed the Poor event recorded one of its largest turnouts on Monday. 7 years ago, the man with a vision opened his doors to feed the nation's poor and destitute. Over the past years, the organization has seen an increase in its numbers, and at its annual celebration was no different.
It was very challenging to host a staff party, you know. There were many sponsors who sponsored me last year, and they couldn't contribute this year. But little is much when God is in it. So I know my lawyer and CFL will endorse what we are doing today.
Despite challenges in hosting the event, Feed the Poor Ministry received sponsorship from several entities, including the government of St. Lucia, Bay Gardens Hotel, and Consolidated Foods Limited.
One of the projects that we must engage in with Mr. Gasper is this Christmas feeding of those in need. We take great pleasure in being a part of this activity, along with many other corporate sponsors, and this is a very admirable, very commendable initiative.
Some who are in dire need of food, clothing, and perhaps shelter would have been left to roam elsewhere if Feed the Poor Ministry was not incorporated 7 years ago by City Attorney Colin Foster.
The foundation of that is the good intention and the good works put in by Mr. Gasper and his associates. And I feel that truly the chart of the destiny of this company must be marked by the elements of longevity and continued existence.
The Feed the Poor Ministry activity took place at the Castries Town Hall. Reporting for the DBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.